The U.S. has been encouraging allies to restrict Huawei from their telecommunications networks. Security officials say that Beijing could force the Chinese company to spy or even disable countries' networks. So far, Australia and New Zealand have moved to block Huawei in their 5G rollout. But some European countries have hesitated, saying that Huawei equipment is much cheaper. Plus, there's no public evidence that Huawei has or could use its equipment to eavesdrop. But even if allied countries bend to U.S. pressure, it may be nearly impossible to extract Huawei from a country's network where it's already ingrained. Here's why. Countries are rushing to test and roll out 5G networks, seeing that the potential payoffs are immense. The first phase for many carriers will be to upgrade existing 4G networks. That means attaching 5G components to legacy infrastructure. And guess where much of that legacy hardware comes from? Huawei. For the first three quarters of 2018, the Chinese company had a 28% share of the global telecom equipment market. Nokia and Ericsson are falling behind. Take a close look at Huawei's presence in each region. Outside of North America, the tech juggernaut outpaces its Nordic rivals. So to take Huawei out of the network, whether it's 4G or 5G, countries first have to replace existing infrastructure provided by the company. And that's a big chunk of time and money. Carriers have opposed banning Huawei, pointing to its superior hardware and lower prices. Take a small U.S. rural carrier as an example. James Valley Telecommunications says all of its wireless core network and radios are from Huawei. It says it will cost around $5,000 per subscriber if it has to replace the entire network. Given that it's currently servicing about 10,000 rural customers, the network replacement cost will total $50 million. And it goes beyond just the money. Telaga Research, a wireless technology research firm, says a typical network replacement cycle takes 5 to 10 years to complete. So even if the U.S. were to ban Huawei in 5G, carriers can still expect that Huawei won't be out of the network immediately. Outside of Huawei, Nokia and Ericsson aren't gaining much favor among European carriers. Wireless providers say that they've been slow to release equipment as advanced as Huawei's. Some of Huawei's 5G technology can be up to a year ahead of its Western rivals, according to some senior executives. Huawei's clout in 5G stems from its massive research and development budget. In 2017, Huawei spent $13 billion on R&D, more than its chief rivals combined. The company now owns the most number of standard essential 5G patents in the world. Some of those are now fundamental building blocks to 5G. They include one highly prized technique called polar coding, a method for correcting errors in data transmission. Regardless of whether a country chooses to block Huawei, there's no way to avoid paying royalties to license its 5G technology. With Huawei at the center of the 5G race, governments and carriers aren't ready to abandon it yet. Unlike in the US, officials in Germany and the UK still believe they can allow some Huawei equipment in their countries.